Chapter 10. Billy the Frog. As Christina Bee approached Cedar Springs Creek, she couldn't help notice how different the forest appeared at this time of the early evening. The colours were different, the sounds were different, even the breeze carried different smells, which she was sure would give Reggie the fox food for thought for a long time. The little honeybee was sleepy, but determined to find out what kind of a creature would make such a noise as she was hearing. Billy. 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 The unseen creature responded. Hello, who's there? Called Christina Bee. Billy. 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 Repeated the voice. Come out so I can see you, requested Christina Bee. There was a shuffling of leaves and grass at the edge of Cedar Springs Creek, followed by more. Billy. 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 Christina Bee settled on a wildflower at the edge of the creek and waited for the voice to be given a face. After a few moments, a curious-looking creature emerged from the long grass and formally introduced himself.
I'm Billy. I'm a Cope's grey tree frog, an amphibian, he said, almost as if he were looking down his nose at the little honeybee. And who might you be? He inquired.
I'm Christina Bee, she answered. A very tired little honeybee, I'm afraid. It's almost way past my bedtime, she added, pausing to listen to what she had just said and wondered if it actually made sense. She shrugged and spoke again to Billy the Frog. What's an amphibian? She inquired.
An amphibian is a creature that can live both on the land and in the water, responded Billy. I can actually breathe in the air and under the water. When I was younger, I breathed entirely under the water. Now I can do both. One time I lived for months in the mud, breathing only through my skin.
Really? I'm afraid I can't do anything as exciting as that, apologized Christina Bee.
I'm sure you must make some contribution to the world around you. All of us have our place, you know, replied Billy.
To look at, Billy the Frog was greenish-grey-brown in colour. His skin had dark blotches and was somewhat rough in appearance. He was most at ease in what Christina Bee thought looked like a sitting position. His shape was plumpish and he appeared to be always looking upward. Even though he was young, he had an air of authority about him, and his tone was as if he were very wise. Christina Bee wished she weren't so sleepy. She would love to spend more time with Billy and learn how he made the fascinating sounds he produced. I'm so happy to meet you, I really am, she said. But I just have to get home before I fall asleep right here in the flower patch. My family live in a nearby beech tree and everybody will be tucked in for the night by now.
We'll meet again, Billy assured her. I actually live in the trees myself. I only come down to the water for just a short while at this time of the year.
Even though she was very tired, Christina Bee thought of many questions she would like to ask Billy. But before she could respond, Billy stretched himself out and sprang from the bank of the creek, offering a flash of yellow from the underside of his long muscular legs, which, while he was sitting, were hidden from the view of the little honeybee. With a motion of grace, which surprised Christina Bee, he plunged into the water and swam down the stream. The action was so fast, Christina Bee almost missed it. Yes, well, goodbye to you too, she called to Billy as he quickly disappeared from her view. The last rays of the sun were retreating over the horizon, and Cedar Springs Forest brought forth a new set of sounds which lulled to sleep the creatures of the day, who by now were settled into their homes for the night, and awakened the creatures of the evening. Christina Bee buzzed her way high up in her beech tree home where the rest of her large family had gathered and ceased their busyness for the day. She stopped for a moment or two at the entrance to the hive and enjoyed a short time of reflection on her day and the new friends she had made. Christina Bee sometimes wished the days were longer, giving her more time to enjoy the world in which she lived. But for now, she would surrender to the peaceful weariness that had settled upon her and look forward to the morning when the sun would rise again, bringing its freshness and joy. The little western honeybee enjoyed the sense of security she felt among the many members of her family, and as she settled into her place, she wondered to herself, "What will tomorrow bring?" Good night, Christina Bee. We'll see you again next time. Harvey the Raccoon's mailbox home provides the perfect place for dropping off messages for Christina Bee and her friends. Email can be sent to this address, cedarspringsforest@gmail.com. Write soon! You have been listening to Up a Tree with Christina Bee, written and narrated by Tony Harriman. If you'd like to find more adventures from Cedar Springs Forest, please visit soundimpression.org and look for Christina Bee. We hope you have enjoyed visiting Christina Bee and her friends. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye-bye for now.